Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So this is Raja from IIT Madras. So before starting the video, let me briefly introduce myself. So I've completed my MS in Electrical Engineering from IIT Madras, and along with my MS, I simultaneously completed BS in Data Science and Application from IIT Madras in hybrid mode. And before my MS and BS, I've completed my BTech in Electrical Engineering from NIT Raipur. So a lot of you were asking, after completing all this degree, what are your future plans, what are your career plans, and what are your next steps? So to be honest, I was also really confused what will be my next step. So it is quite true that if you have multiple options, then you become really confused and you wanted to go for the best option. So the same thing happened for me as well. So I was really confused, and the lot of mental hassle going inside myself. So at that time I was really confused what would be a best option for me considering the situation. So after completing my MS in Electrical Engineering from IIT Madras, I had really basically two options: either to sit for the campus placement and go for a corporate job or any job, or to go for a PhD and go into the research world or academia, either abroad or in India. So I was really confused which option would be a better option for me. Let me tell you why. So after completing my BTech journey in Electrical Engineering from NIT Raipur, at that point I had not taken any job. I really jumped into my master journey at IIT Madras. So I have not experienced or not exposed to the corporate world so far. So far my journey was in the academia only, and the academia journey is quite smooth and steady. But in the corporate world or any job dynamics, you will face the real life challenges, and you will learn a lot of things which you will not learn in the academia setting. So I really wanted to learn and experience that dynamics as well, because that is also really important for your career as well as your life. So I was really interested into that as well. And apart from that, I had spent around 2.5 or 3 years into my research. So I was really enjoying the research journey, although at some point research journey was quite disappointing and quite depressing as well. So but still, overall my journey, research journey, was quite smooth, and I was really enjoying and wanted to delve deeper into my research problem and wanted to contribute something great to the scientific community. So for that I needed to go for a PhD so that I can approach the problem deeply and do a better research. So my research was in the field of computer vision image processing applied to the medical setting. So I was really enjoying that, and I wanted to do PhD as well. So I was really confused and torn between these two options. So I talked with a lot of people, took their opinion, but still at the end I listened to myself only. So what would be the best option, that can be decided by yourself only. You can take the opinions from others and experience from others, but at the end you have to decide what would be the best option for you. So after talking to a lot of PhD students abroad or India, talking with the professors, mentors, so I got to know a lot of things about the PhD, how the PhD works, how the research works, how is the life after PhD, how the options after the PhD, and how much is the stipend, money, and all. So after considering all the pros and cons of the PhD, I at the end decided to hold the decision for PhD as of now. So taking the decision for a PhD is a very big and important decision, and you have to take it very seriously, because once you take it, after 1 to 3 years, you will not have the option to go back. But if you go for the job, you can easily switch back to the PhD and can do the PhD anytime. So PhD is like not a mandatory option. It is a optional decision which can be taken by the individual who want to delve deeper into the subject. So at this point, I decided to hold that and will pursue the PhD later. So I went for my first option, that I sat for the campus placement and got a job. So I was really looking to the job profile in which I can apply my principles and learning whichever I studied throughout my the BTEC, MS and the BA journey. So all these 3 degrees helped me a lot during the campus placement. So because your learnings never become old, it only evolved over time. So it always helped to get a job, or so because your knowledge does not expire, so it only evolves. And if you update yourself with skills, if you update your skills and knowledge and practice quite well, then getting a job is not difficult. So when I set for the campus placement, although I got rejected by a lot of companies, and I got to learn a lot of things about myself, and I was able to introspect what things are going wrong. So many times I also got depressed, like why I am not getting the job. But at the end, if you have knowledge and the skill, then you can easily secure a job. So I am quite happy that I got the job in which my research and my learning is also applied. So I got a job as an AI engineer in an AI startup called Hakimo.ai, which works on the remuneralizing the camera surveillance and remote guarding through the application of AI. And I really like the vision of the company. And apart from the vision, and idea, the thing which matters the most is the execution. And I am really liking the execution of the vision in this company. And so far my journey is quite exciting. And apart from the excitement, there are a lot of things to learn, and a lot of new challenges are there every day. And it is always good to have the new challenges, because challenges force you to come out the cell and do something extra. So it is always better to have some challenges in your life. With the challenges only you can learn something and update yourself. So this is my journey, and this is my actually first job, because after BTEC I have not taken any job, although I have done some internship, still the first job always is the first job, and it is always quite exciting, and you always remember your first job. So so far my journey into the first job is quite good, and I hope by learning and by updating your skill, you will also be able to land up in your first job, and the most importantly in the job which excites you the most. So with this, I want to take a leave, and I hope this video will motivate you to work harder and learn and upskill yourself. So if you have not yet subscribed, please do subscribe. I will come with some another video in the channel which motivate you further. So far, thank you so much. Happy learning.